the palate was not purist. My parts on Catch a Fire are nowhere near purist. They are an imitation of what Bob Marley taught me how to do. And so while over there reggae, I was doing that.
This record had the most overdubs on it. This record was the most, I don't say softened, but I more say enhanced to try and reach a rock market, because this was the first record and they wanted to reach into that market.
First ever reggae group on the Old Grey Whistle Test was quite a coup, I think, and I think probably some of the audience was upset to see that, but it also, you know, it was just one more thing that drew the Wailers into the mainstream and made them acceptable.
Slave driver, the table is turned.
The music hits you, but you feel no pain. But it's happening. And it's the same thing with the message. It hits you, but you don't feel no pain. What it does for you is to give you a vision and a reason to change your lifestyle, your convictions, you know, it's like a purge.
My blood run cold. I remember on a slave ship how they brutalized our very soul. Hey, they say that we are free only to be chained in the poverty. I know it's illiteracy. It's only a machine that make money. Slave driver, table is turned. Get your fire. Only get burned.
Came with songs like Slave Drive, it was a total revolution within the music itself, the industry. The people needed that revolution because there were things that had to be dealt with, that singing about love could not deal with it within the focus of I love you.
We come to find out that we were living in this ghetto, so-called, with, you know, consist of poor people, 99%. And there were people who were living in the, you know, the general system who, you know, has no one to help them, no one to do nothing for them. So, and we live in the same administration. So, well, we are the only one who can express the people's feeling through music. And because we can do that, the people love it.
Group is the Wailers. Well, for some reason, them say Bob Marley and the Wailers. I never tell no one to say that from no time at all. But maybe for some reason, them do it, you know.
Yeah.
Well, I man is a Wailers, you know, and it's just at rest.
Even until this day, don't make no man tell a different. To me, Wailers was like a family, still is. Even though Bob and Peter might not be here, Wailers was like and still is a family up to this day.
Reggae music is the heartbeat of the people, you know. It's the universal language. The Bible says one good thing about it, when it hits, you feel no pain. So we're trying to express the lyrics within the melody. So within that roots, that reggae roots, with that R&B flavor, to get it across the board. You know, at first the song start with a kind of omen sound from the harmony, you know. Both three singers singing this sound like, ooh, you know. So it further give us a line like, like a moan feeling. Yeah. It's a slave driver, that's what we call it.
Between myself, Bob, and Peter, we had to find a formula that would be acceptable. So what we did was lay down a hard driving rhythm that suggests the basic reggae principles. And then now we would put little bits and colorings of here and there that would not take away from the basic principle, but would attract the international marketplace.
Tape that's playing now is the a rough mix of the original recording in Jamaica. Probably the tape that Chris Blackwell made his decisions to of where to go with the album. This came over with the original tapes. Effectively, everything is there. The atmosphere is there, which is 98% of it, as far as I'm concerned. So we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tracks on the original tape. Baby, baby, we've got a date. I can just show you here, that's the drums. All the drums are mixed to one track. And then other tracks would have, this is guitar and piano mixed together. And it's an interesting feature of the Jamaican reggae music, because they were tight with the number of tracks they had available. They record everything in the same room, and I believe that contributes greatly to the sound, the overall sound, because the different instruments feed down the different microphones, so that the combination of the sound is quite... And then we added in some slide guitar with Wayne Perkins.
So I'm listening, and I'm sitting here trying to figure out what's going on, and I can't find the one. To save my ass, I cannot find the one. So I'm going, Chris, what's going on? He said, just stop and listen to it. Don't listen to the bass. And they brought the bass down for me just a little bit. I said, all right. I'm listening. All of a sudden, something starts to settle in, and I'm going, okay. All right. So I said, all right, roll tape.